Okay lah, not bad, not bad lah. Zaman-zaman sebelum bass boy untuk menjadi bass boy. Okay, now kita baru masuk. Now I nak tanya you bila masuk first step jadi bass boy tu. Let's talk about I think routine yang orang first kenal you for. Bohe-bohe. Cerita sikit. Cerita sikit proses tu, proses je.
Okay, it's not bohe, it's not bass boy. First routine I is bass low. The first original routine I, yeah, I buat sebab time tu I tengah jamming dekat rumah Azim sebab ada open house kan. So time tu RC semua ada and then we are jamming dekat ruang tamu Amin punya house lah. So I try lah to show off my input bass kan. And then RC told that, oh bro, that's dope bro, that's dope. So RC macam, why not, what? Aku tak tahu lah dia cakap apa tentu dah lama kan tak ingat, tapi dia sarankan aku untuk buat rutin dengan that drop lah. So that is the first the first routine I created and then suggested we have apa from RC. So yeah, to be slow, and the second pun RC juga yang tolong. Yeah, that which is his bass boy. So bass boy memang itu rutin yang aku rasa first time aku rasa rutin yang best bagi aku lah. Waktu tu kan tak reti buat rutin semua kan, baru tiba-tiba orang semua. Lepas tu bila dia buat lirik semua tu aku macam appreciate as fuck tau. Macam, oh dope, this lyric is dope. My mama told me that shouldn't treat me like a toy. Dia cakap, mak saya cakap jangan layan saya macam apa mainan kan. Macam, oh fuck man, that's good. So I'm like, oh, I'm gonna simpan this in battle semua kan. So from that start, I practice lah kau-kau. Tapi bila lama-kelamaan tu, bila dah masuk dah lama-lama beatbox tu, so dah jadi bosan sikit dengan rutin tu. So I evolve lagi, which is Adam evolvekan bagi idea. So bila tu, and then bila time tu I dah macam dah pandai sikit apa create rutin kan. So I try to matching freestyle sikit, matching freestyle sikit, and then boom! Jadi bass boy baru. So yeah,
itu bass boy 2.0 doh.
Yeah, thanks to you bro.
Maji.
Okay, next question.
Next question. Let's go. So okay lah. Terkejut juga actually bila you jadi champ masa on BN 2018, you pun terkejut lah juga sebab you pun kata at the time routine tak banyak, you freestyle kan mostly.
Betul.
So I think nak nak tanya is that your mentality before you menjadi champion dan after you menjadi champion, like apa beza dia?
Okay, before I jadi champion tu, my mentality I'm afraid of you because you join juga. I'm afraid of stage. And I'm fucking afraid of AFQ tu, tapi AFQ tak join, so I'm happy as fuck. So like sebab time tu I macam apa ni, tak biasa lagi dengan stage kan. Sebab I pernah join Arma semua, Arma 2017 semua, I macam I buat memang sampah lah I punya elimination semua kan. Sebab I tak biasa lagi apa, nak confident atas stage tu bila beatbox depan orang ramai macam tu. So confident I tu macam tak berapa sangat lah. Tapi before after yang workshop tu, kan ada workshop sebelum battle kan, yang kita workshop orang ramai tu dekat dalam kelas tu. And then bila masa I balik tu, I macam I fikir lah macam, this is the moment lah bro, this is the time to be a champion lah. I try lah. So I list out of my routine walaupun tak banyak. Lepas tu I try to buat routine lah, simple routine, really simple routine, which is ada drop satu, drop dua, macam simple routine lah walaupun dia tak tempat kan. So I banyak buat research jugalah malam tu. And then I tidur awal, bangun pagi tu sebelum nak ke Beatbox Battle event tu, I practice lah. So I practice banyak-banyak kali, tapi bila battle tu tak jadi pun practice. Dia macam jadi freestyle semua. Dia macam berterabur lah sebab bila you battle dengan orang kan, and then dia buat beat tu, mesti you nak counter right. So plan you memang tak jadi. Yeah. You have to do it macam spontan lah.
Yeah, on the spot lah, on the fly lah. Kalau anything happen, itu kan. Yeah, betul.
Yes, Tapi the routine semua, plan tu ada je yang kena jadi masa I lawan dengan Felix semua tu. Yang tu memang I plan lah, all plan. And then bila dah better-better tu, bila you dah rasa menang setiap round by round, and then you rasa macam, oh man, the confidence is gain. You gain confidence round by round, and bila you dah menang. And then until I meet Justin, I'm like, oh fuck man, this guy is gonna kill me. And then what I did is I try to be a clown, I guess. Macam jadi tarik attention orang untuk tengok I. So orang tak dengar sangat beat Justin. So bila I bebok tu, so apa yang cakap dia, aku lupa lah. Bila I dah menang tu, that Justin punya round, I'm like, oh fuck man, that was a close battle. And so I really, memang best lah rasa dia. And then bila dah jadi champion tu, I'm like, ah fuck man, this is the best feeling ever lah. And then after I jadi champion tu, of course lah, I try to be more powerful. And so suddenly I lepak kat mamak. Ini cerita lain lah. Dah habis battle tu, seminggu lepas tu I lepak kat mamak kan. I sorang-sorang kan, lepas makan tu I macam lepak-lepak buat whistle. Sebab time tu kan I baru belajar whistle, that rally whistle. And then
yes
I try to tutup mulut kan, macam like tutup mulut, guna tekat mulut kan, bunyi macam double kan. So like bila minta dalam group tu, macam orang kata, ooh dope. Lepas tu orang kata, eh ni guna mulut, guna tangan ni kan. So I try to do it without tangan lah, without hands. So and then surprisingly I can do it. So I macam, oh fuck man, there's a new sound for me. Padahal ada je orang dah buat, tapi tak popular lagi lah whistle tu. And then yeah, from that moment, it came to my new routine is feel the power. So yeah.
Asyad lah kau Aizan. Kau dah asyad tu Aizan. Sumpah kau dah asyad.
Yeah.
Hai. Dari bass, dari bunyi-bunyi bass, last-last bunyi burung whistle. Ya Allah. Macam story dia, macam you go to one side, mesti go to the other. I think itu yang buat kau unik though. Like, kau flavor lain macam.
Tak, dia macam ni cakap, dia macam luck juga lah. Sebab I belajar whistle tu, I tengok tutorial kan, I lepak-lepak ambil dia tengok tutorial kan. Tengok, ada kan Sir Effects ada buat tutorial yang I dah ada cerita dalam group semua. Like, I belajar dalam 2 hari je, like. I macam, what the fuck, I dapat kan. Sebab tu I guna dekat on beat and then boom. I champion.
Bada boom, bada bing, champion, the win. Hei, gila. Okay lah. So okay lah, after jadi champion semua tu kan, like I think the next chapter is pahlawan, dude. Pahlawan is the next chapter in your so-called career.
Yep.
So-called pula, memang career pun.
That's right.
So like initially like,
jajah.
Why apa?
Okay, cakap balik.
Okay lah, aku nak tanya pasal a bit pasal pahlawan lah, right? So like you dah dengar C4 so for quite a while, but tu you pun achieve banyak dalam short amount of time. And so what is it like performing dalam tag team lah compared dengan solo? Like what's the difference lah?
Tag team dengan solo, apa difference dia? Dia punya experience dia sama je bagi aku. Tapi bila experience yang paling banyak aku dapat masa dekat Wayoof lah. Mostly Wayoof, sebab time tu kan dah lah first tag team battle kita orang. And then kita orang jadi champion pula tu. So like is memang tak sangka lah. Memang tak sangka sangat, sebab kita orang practice pun tak adalah banyak mana practice. Tapi kita practice time sebelum battle tu, kita practice kau-kau je lah lebih kurang. Tapi kita sebelum tu dekat Malaysia pun kita orang ada meet up selalu, sebab RC yang selalu bagi, dia yang selalu reka idea semua kan. So for me the experience dia tak ada beza mana, cuma experience masa dekat Wayoof tu pahlawan dia memang best lah, rasa dia memang
fresh, rasa mentah.
grateful lah. Rasa fresh walaupun kita orang tu tengah penat. And then walaupun at that time aku lulus masuk apa jadi sebagai solo kan, solo kategori untuk Way of Beatbox Battle Champion tu. Tapi aku tak ready lah sebab memang aku penat gila. And then my routine pun tak banyak sangat yang solid lagi. And tak banyak lagi lah input semua. And then I try to focus more on pahlawan lah, tag team lah. So yeah, experience dia or dekat Werewolf is pahlawan punya tag team lah, tag team champion lah.